The election of several lawmakers to key posts at the House of Representatives not sitting well with some of their colleagues. RJ Cruz gives us the latest on the reorganization of the upper and lower houses of Congress.
Albay 1st District Representative Edsel Lagman and New House Minority Leader Marcelino Libana did not mince words against each other after Lagman flagged Libana's election as a minority leader, who he claimed was handpicked by the majority.
Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, let me start by expressing my disappointment and disenchantment in the new House leadership's and the new administration's perpetuating the practice of anointing the majority's minority leader. This is an open secret, a brutal fact.
In this August chamber, we are required to observe proper decorum. We are required to observe proper parliamentary language and proper parliamentary courtesy, Mr. Speaker. We have to go to our Constitution. Mr. Speaker, for a veteran legislator to stand there and give some insinuations to the members of minority, if not put into proper place, will not be good for our chamber.
Lagman cites the badges of interference, such as when Libanan thanked the majority after his election, taking his oath before the speaker, and Libanan asking for the plenary's approval when he picked the minority's representatives to the House committees. Libanan no longer responded to Lagman. Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel, meanwhile, flagged the election of presidential son, Ilocos Norte 1st District Representative Sandro Marcos as senior deputy majority leader. But Representative Margarita Nograles fired back, insisting on Marcos's qualification for the job, citing his knowledge and experience from understudying at the majority leader's office when his uncle, the current speaker, had that post. Albay Representative Joey Salceda says being the son of the president makes Representative Marcos an asset to the House and its members.
Hindi mo na kailangan duman sa KES. So hindi mo na kailangan i-filter pa yung messaging. So kung anong problema sa House, makakarap niya agad kay Presidente. So mas mapapabilis po ang legislative meal.
Former Senator, now Batangas Representative Ralph Recto, Pampanga Representative Aurelio Don Gonzalez, and Cebu Representative Duke Frasco were elected to become the 7th, 8th, and 9th Deputy Speaker of the House. The Speaker's wife, Tingog Party List Representative Yeda Romualdez, would be in charge of the House's institutional purse as Chair of the House Committee on Accounts, while a key ally of the Speaker, Acobico Representative Zaldi Co, would be in charge of the national budget as Chair of the House Committee on Appropriations. Other chairmen of key House committees have been named as well. At the Senate, Senator Francis Tolentino now heads the powerful Blue Ribbon Committee, Senator Sani Angara, the Finance Committee, and Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, the Ways and Means Committee. Two committees, Foreign Relations and Social Justice, Welfare and Rural Development, went to the President's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.